but today you're doing my job, you're hosting. How's that going so far?
It's going good. I just had my first interview.
You interviewed a race car driver who does off-roading?
I did. His name's Justin Peck. He's an amazing advocate for mental health. And so for my show, we're talking a lot about mastering the mind. What tools do we use for mastering the mind? And what tips can we get from amazing top athletes and people in their industry? So he gave me two really good, amazing tips. So yeah, it was a great interview.
Now I follow you on Instagram. You always post up with Native American stuff. Yeah. Are you Native American?
I'm not. I'm actually Fulani and Greek and a little bit of Spanish. But I just love the indigenous culture and I just respect them a lot. I like to pay homage to people who have been basically genocide from our country.
I gotta ask you a couple of boxing really quick. Shane Mosley's training Red Catch. Yes. Red Catch does not have an opponent.
Yes.
Who do you want to see him fight next?
I mean, Ivan really, really wants to fight Adrian Broner. I think Adrian Broner is a bit out of shape. The last I saw him at the Porter fight, I saw some video, he looked a little bit like he's not training. So I was like, Ivan, I really don't think that fight's going to happen. I think you guys should be focusing on a list of any other guy who's a contender in the welterweight industry. Now that he has Shane as his trainer, he is a serious contender. This guy has never had a really, really solid trainer.
That focus just on him, like Shane is, makes a big difference.
Yeah, because his trainer before, I think it was Santa Cruz.
Yes, Leo's dad.
Yeah,
but Leo's the star.
Yeah, he's the star. He's not focused on him. And Shane, he didn't want to train. He just wanted to retire, if you know what I mean. But Ivan kept persistently emailing, messaging. And so finally, he was like, one day, I'll train you one day. So
and then
one day turned into, he's like, I love this kid. He's like, he's going to be a world champion. He's like, seriously crazy. He's like, this kid works as hard as I did. I don't have to motivate him like I did some of the other fighters. He's like, he could be a world champion. He's like, he could beat Sean Porter. He's like, he could beat Keith Thurman. He's like, he could beat anyone. He really believes he could beat.
They already had a major upset with Devin Alexander.
Yes!
Shocked the world.
No. He only trained him for six sessions. That's it. They worked over and over and over on how to knock him out. Shane is like a guru on how to defeat people. Because he's such a good fighter, he can
learn. Oh, big congratulations! Shane's on the Hall of Fame ballot!
Thank you.
Did you see that? They made a ballot for the Hall of Fame, and they added a bunch of names for the main Nevada Boxing Hall of Fame. Not Nevada, Boxing Hall of Fame.
What?
And Shane is among the nine names.
Yeah, the first I heard.
I gotta find it. But
thank you, Ed Brophy. That's amazing.
Let's see here. Hold on one second. Here are the names. Look, Shane Mosley on the bottom over there. You see him?
Wow.
Now.
Wait, let me see who his competition is. Are these his competition?
Yeah, only five. You can only pick five.
Five? Okay, so I'm going with Tim Bradley, Diego Corrales. Shane was actually there the day that he passed away.
Wow.
Yeah, he was there with the show. Bernard Hopkins, of course. Shane Mosley, and is that five? How many men? If I can get one more, I'm going to go with Marquez.
Oh, Casamayor, Marquez, of course. They're all good. Now, I got to ask you this. You watched a Porter Spence fight.
Yeah.
How did you have the fight?
You know, I thought that Spence was going to dominate Sean Porter. And, you know, we've been friends with the Porters for some time. So, it wasn't like we were hoping that he would dominate. We just kind of thought that he would because he's just supposedly this most amazing fighter ever. And Sean, I don't know what he was coming to win. Like, I think it was really close. I do think that Errol Spence won. But it was close. It was closer than anyone thought it was, right?
Trista, tell people where to follow you.
Yes, follow me on Instagram, Trista Pisani. You can also follow my spiritual page for tips on energy, meditation, chakras at becoming.ion.
All right, make sure to follow her. And big things coming. We can't tell you guys, but stay tuned. Hopefully, Shane is the first ballot Hall of Famer. Please look forward to that conversation.